The MACRAGGE'S Honor serves as the flagship of the Ultramarines during the 41st millennium. One of the storied Gloriana-class battleships bestowed to the Primarchs of the Imperium, the 26-kilometer-long vessel has seen many battles during the darkest days of his Imperium. During the days of the Horus Heresy, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would endure its first battle against the traitors of humanity in orbit of the planet of Calf. Betrayed by the Wordbearer's Legion, the Ultramarines and their Primarch would fight a desperate battle of survival aboard the MACRAGGE'S Honor and its surrounding fleet. Infiltrated by the treacherous 17th Legion and a horde of warp-spawn demons, the Ultramarines would battle to preserve their storied and indomitable flagship. The overwhelming power of the Gloriana vessel would annihilate several void ships of the Wordbearer's fleet and lead the speartip of the Ultramarines' retaliation. The 13th would push back the Wordbearers, yet incur heavy losses and damages from the Calf atrocity. Giving command of the MACRAGGE'S Honor to Chapter Master Marius Gage, Primarch Roboute Guilliman would entrust his flagship to the First Master during his assignment to hunt down the Dark Cardinal of the Wordbearers, Cor Faeron. Pursuing the fleeing Wordbearers' fleet and its command vessel, the Infidus Imperator, the two warships would engage. Gage would command Captain Arion Mercerore to infiltrate the Infidus Imperator as the two vessels unleashed their broadsides. Summoning a burst of warp energy, the Wordbearers would cripple both warships during the battle and allow for traitor Astartes and demons to once again infest the MACRAGGE'S Honor. Regaining control of the flagship, the Ultramarines would watch as the Infidus Imperator fled from the skirmish. Gage would command all hands to continue pursuit of Cor Faeron and follow the crazed First Captain into a rend of space created with the Aphame Dagger, the Shard of Erebus. Within warp space, Cor Faeron would employ many tricks to prevent his pursuers from sundering his warship. Once more besieged by beings of the Immaterium, the crew of the MACRAGGE'S Honor would be distracted long enough for Cor Faeron to counterattack. Incurring severe damage, all would seem lost until Captain Mercerore would allow for the MACRAGGE'S Honor to target the Infidus Imperator by activating a homing tracer within its hull. Diverting all power to destroy the Wordbearer ship, two volleys would seal the warship's fate as another husk strewn across the void. Though Cor Faeron would survive, the Wordbearers had been routed, yet with their task fulfilled, at the cost of stranding the Ultramarines' flagship within the warp. Suffering extensive damage during the battle against the Infidus Imperator, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would drift, rudderless within the Immaterium. For decades, perhaps even centuries, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would slowly sail towards Ultramar. Reuniting with the Ultramarines during an unknown time, Gage and his men would return to their homeworld to find their Primarch, Roboute Guilliman, interred within a stasis chamber. The Lord of Ultramar had been wounded by the Venetian of the Emperor's children, Fulgrim, and damned the now chapter of the Ultramarines to their long vigil without the guidance of their genefather. Aiding in the great scouring of the traitors, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would hunt down the betrayers of humanity and remain active as one of the single largest and most deadly vessels within the Imperium. Yet after 10 millennia of dormancy, the Primarch of the 13th would arise once again and lead his Ultramarines in their glorious campaign to reclaim the stars. The MACRAGGE'S Honor had long since been repaired and gained glory at several campaigns won in the name of the chapter. During 999.M41, Abaddon the Despoiler would assault Ultramar during his benighted 13th Black Crusade. Commanded by Chapter Master Marnius Kalgar, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would fight at the vanguard of the Ultramar Defense Fleet against both the Black Legion and the Alpha Legion. Triumphing over the Hydra's fleet, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would now serve as the chariot of the Avenging Sun as he ventured to the Throne World during the years of the Terran Crusade. Trapped within the Maelstrom due to the intervention of the traitor Primarch of the Thousand Suns, Magnus the Red, the MACRAGGE'S Honor would lead the Terran Crusade fleet through the Sorcerer's treacheries. Besieged by demonic servants of the Plague God, with the aid of the living saint of the Order of Our Martyred Lady, Celestine, her holy light would shine from the flagship's bridge and purge the horrors of the warp. Yet such fortunes would be short-lived, as the treacherous Red Corsairs and Greater Demon of Sinch, Kairos Fateweaver, would trap the Terran Crusade within its clutches. The MACRAGGE'S honor would be boarded by the Red Corsairs, and with the aid of the Changer of Ways, the crew would be captured. The mortal crewmen would be sacrificed, and for a time, the MACRAGGE'S honor would become a trophy for the master of the Red Corsairs, Huron Blackheart. However, with the blood of the Imperium's mighty subjects, the MACRAGGE'S honor would be reclaimed from the renegade Space Marines, and once more, return to the Freed Lord Commander of the Imperium. For the Blood Reaver of the Red Corsairs would be unable to utilize the deadly warship for his own means, as the machine spirit of the ancient vessel refused to acquiesce to his demands. Extensively refitted within the Ring of Iron orbiting Mars by the Archmagos Belisarius Call, the Ultramarines flagship was now stronger than ever with its newly incorporated technologies and ancient artifacts. Reconfigured with countless failsafes, crew specialists, and sophisticated cadres of the tech adepts of Mars, the MACRAGGE'S honor sailed into the void, ready to face the enemies of the Imperium. Aiding Admiral Spire during the naval wars against the Warmaster of Chaos, the legendary hero of the Gothic War would be entrusted with the Avenging Sun's most deadly warship, and succeed in thwarting the Despoilers' wicked campaign. Redeployed during the Indomitus Crusade to aid the Ultramarines during the Plague Wars against the revived demon Primarch of Nurgle, Mortarion, the MACRAGGE'S honor would leave the Imperial Navy in their annihilation of the Nurglite invasion forces. To this day, the MACRAGGE'S honor serves as a reminder of the Imperium's gloried past. For there is no vessel in the stars capable of sundering the legacy and valor of the once 500 worlds.